Yes, good evening YouTube. As you can see up here, I've got my attic fans shut off, so they're not running today. I haven't had them on for 3 days, and let me show you the thermometer readings and we can see how effective those fans really are. And this is in response to a couple of viewers wondering if PC fans can actually cool an attic, and I wanted to show you the numbers and we can actually see how they work. Let's cut over to the thermometer here.
Hey, good evening YouTube. So this is my wireless thermometer here. Current temperature, this is outside, is 78 Fahrenheit, and this is the temperature up in the attic. I have a wireless thermometer up there, and the highest I saw it hit today was 104. It's starting to cool down now, and I have my attic fans on today. I've had a few viewers of my attic fan video say that the little computer fans don't do anything and they're incapable of moving any air and so forth. So what I want to do is run an experiment. I did this several years ago when I first put them in. I did the reverse. I measured the temperature before I put in the fans and then measured afterwards, and I noticed about a 10 degree Fahrenheit drop. And then I also put in some radiant foil insulation in the rafter bays, and that again did about a 10 degree drop. I used to notice the temperature up there in the attic would be above 130, usually 133, 134. This is about the hottest time, between 6 and 7 is when the attic gets hot. So what I want to do is I'm going to shut the fans off, and I'll probably have to run it off for a couple of days. Without the fans running, this temperature will get higher during the day, and then it won't get as cool during the night, and then the next day it gets that much hotter, and so you get this kind of upward sawtooth waveform. It gets hotter, doesn't cool off as much, and then gets hotter again. So I wanted to run this test and document this on video. Yeah, good morning YouTube. Just a follow-up. This is the next morning on the attic temperature. So inside the house it's 72, outside is 70, about 10 in the morning, and that's about when the sun hits the roof of the house, comes around the trees on the east side. And if we look here, the attic temperature is only dropped to about 72 last night. Normally this will drop to maybe 68 to 70 with the fans on, because I have the thermostat on the fans set around 70 Fahrenheit, so they'll keep running until the attic gets down to about 70, and then if there's enough time, the natural convective cooling in the attic will bring it down a little lower. Yeah, good evening YouTube. So it's about the same time day later, after I turned the fans off, the temperature outside hit 85 today. It's cooled off a little bit here, and if we look up in the attic, it was 108. I saw 108.9 just maybe half an hour ago. I was waiting to see if it would go up any from there, but essentially it's 5 degrees hotter up in the attic today than it was yesterday with the fans running, and it was a couple degrees warmer this morning at the start. Interesting to note, today the weather service said the high here was 85, and yesterday it was 91. So yesterday it was 6 degrees hotter outside, but the attic was 5 degrees cooler. Yeah, good morning YouTube. Just a quick look at the thermometer here. So the house inside temp is 71 here, and the attic's little over 73, so it's about a degree warmer than it was yesterday at this time. Yeah, good morning YouTube. So this is the third day of running this test, and you can see the temperature inside the house is a little warmer, probably because the attic didn't cool off as much overnight. This is the attic temperature. It's now over 75 degrees, and it had been 72 a couple of days ago, so you can see it just steadily gains a degree or two a day in the morning. Okay, here's the thermometer here, so this reading here is the temperature inside the house, and it's actually several degrees warmer than it was last Saturday. Today's Tuesday, and on Saturday it was the same outside temperature. It hit 91. Here's the outside temperature. It's cooled off to about 87 now. There's the attic. I think it hit about 112 today, but it was 91 outside. Today was 91 outside on Saturday, 3 days ago, and we were running about 104 on Saturday and about 112 today. So you can see without the fans running, that's about 8 degrees warmer, and you can see you get this kind of upward trend in the temperatures. And if I let this go probably for about a week, this temperature here would be up around 120. Because that's the temperatures I was observing in the attic before I put the fans in. But I think I am done with this test. I've at least convinced myself that the fans are still doing something. You know, they're keeping this temperature down. And you might think 7 or 8 degrees isn't that big a deal. But I can really feel the house is much less comfortable today than it was Saturday. Yeah, good evening YouTube. Just wanted to give you one further demonstration. I turned the attic fans on about 1 hour ago, and I've already dropped the attic temperature almost 5 degrees, probably 4.5 degrees since I turned the fans on. Yeah, good evening YouTube. We're up on the roof of my house. This is one of the attic vents here. I don't know if you can see that little piece of spider web right there blowing in the breeze. And if we use my heat gun here, you can see I'm getting 90 93. We switch over to, I think I saw about 35 C on the hottest. Yeah, right there. If you get up inside, yeah, 30 35 34 right there. Definitely hot air coming out of those vents, and I can feel it. You can see the see that blowing on my finger there. The whole attic temperature has dropped 5 degrees in 1 hour, so I think those fans work. Just wanted to give you some visible proof there, so that, I think a thumbs up for those fans. They do the job. So it was hot and sunny today. The sun shines on the panels, goes down to my charge controller into the batteries, and then it runs the fans that are right down below there. There's the two fans blowing air up and out the stack, and there's a total of 8 fans, and I think they do the jobs. Yeah, hopefully that answers everybody's questions. This is now fourth summer they're going into operation, or that they've been operating, no problems yet, and they've been zero cost, zero maintenance, aside from brushing the dust off once a year or so. That's about the only maintenance I do. Anyway, hope that answers everybody's questions. And if you have any others, post up in the comment section down below there. And as always, thanks for watching.